We're good. Sounded bad, but it's fine. No!
It was going to be a three strike.
A three-time clap.
Stole my moment. All right.
Zoom in on all three.
No, go ahead.
Yeah, let's do it. No, that's actually a good idea. Oh, there we go. Welcome to Retro Wrenches. So today we're going to try to do a couple things.
The impossible.
Inconceivable.
It might be impossible, yeah. But or plausible. I think you meant plausible.
That's right. Yeah.
So we're going to take the engine. We're going to see if we can get it sitting in here the way we want it. And we got bolts for the exhaust. What? What you looking at?
I thought the dog put that in last time.
She was supposed to.
No.
There's a reason she's not here.
You couldn't fire somebody if they were horrible, doing a terrible job.
Okay.
Yeah, she's suspended. Hey, right, let's get after it.
Well, I missed a couple episodes. I understood maybe that you guys like snacks of some sort. I didn't know what to get. Probably if I would have paid more attention in the episodes, I probably would have got a clue or something, but this is what I got.
Nice.
And some kitty litter.
Well, you and Kaylin can eat these. I really don't like Funyuns. See, if you would have watched the other ones, you'll catch up. You'll see.
Okay.
You'll clearly see that.
I
don't really.
I just wanted to look.
Hey, well, that's still awesome. You guys will have something to eat.
I'll eat the Funyuns, but I'm not eating the kitty litter.
Oh, come on.
That's just if you need a little extra crunch.
Yeah.
It's made out of clay.
That's why I love Nestle Crunch.
Nestle Crunch?
Yeah. Do you remember that one, Dad?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's why I love Nestle Crunch.
Nestle Crunch. We don't have any cats, but we have the most kitty litter on the block. Looks like I came prepared this time. I got these. I got some jerky. And my dad brought some Funyuns, which I don't think I'll eat, but you'll eat.
Funyuns, come on, man. They're fun. You one-upped me, though, because I got the small bag.
Yeah. Little baby bag. That's all right. They're still friends.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
You know, just in case you need to have a far.
Wait, this one. You want this one, Bert?
I don't care. I just brought some boxes.
Oh, you brought boxes.
Yeah.
To burn or
no? To it's fine. I can get more. Colt just said bring boxes. Those ones are
that's a good start.
Past due.
This one might be.
Yeah.
This one might be damaged.
Yep.
Now all of this we won't be able to burn. There's some of this we
see that's
burn.
Also why we had you the fireman. See
gasket
doesn't burn. It sounds like a challenge.
That heat does feel good.
Yeah.
That breeze feels good.
Well, we just had our first fail of the day.
Well, it's not a fail.
Well, okay, we had our first experiment.
It's measuring.
Yeah.
This is an incorrect measurement. So see?
I know what we need to do though. We need bigger tires.
Yeah.
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 That's funny. All right. Well, let's flip her sideways. Nice, man.
Yeah.
It's looking good.
It's coming along, cleaning it up, polishing it a little bit.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. Didn't we get some boxes you wanted to open?
Yes, actually. Wow. Duct tape. Did I ship this? Do you have a knife?
I do, actually.
Okay.
This is a really bad idea, Morty.
Oh, yep.
America. Whoa, it's got We the People on it.
Yeah, that's right.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah.
I can't read that, though.
It's hard. You got to kind of, like, tilt it.
Well, it's in cursive.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in cursive.
Cursive? They stopped teaching that one.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
I'm not left-handed.
I am not left-handed.
So as you saw in the last video, we put the old truck harness back on it and it worked, but it's got all these, it's got all this fluff, as we can call it, that we don't need. Like, okay, well, we need this one, but like these. Okay, we might need those. Okay, like this, we don't need that. Actually, we need that part. Okay, well, anyway, you get the picture, okay? We ordered a very nicely done custom wiring harness, pre-wired, ready to go, and I don't have to wire all those pink wires together because it comes with the fuses, the relays, ignition. So this tidies it up very nice. So it's got this bulkhead seal.
That's neat.
That is pretty neat.
Yeah.
How neat is that?
I'm gonna take this off. Kalen's got his thing he's gonna do.
Yep.
Juno's not here, so we're a little short-staffed.
We'll make it work.
We'll make it work.
I've always wanted to deep fry a turkey
and
smoke a turkey.
Well, if you smoke a turkey, how do you keep it lit?
You gotta have a lot of flame.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
You know, I've smoked a turkey before.
Have you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he didn't get out of the way and I hit him right with my car. Look, I felt bad.
I've come pretty close.
Yeah.
On the highway right over here,
uh-huh.
There was like, I'm not even joking, probably 20 turkeys in the road. And I could have if I wanted to, but I didn't want to.
Yeah. Oh, sweet.
It's a baby.
I think that'll be a lot more manageable.
It's a baby.
That is a baby.
It's just a baby.
I wonder what Tom Cruise is doing today.
Yeah, old Tom Cruise, man.
So, I'm going to spray some PB Blaster on these things. Dude, look, I'm like way over here. Or I'll turn around. There, it's selfie.
On a
selfie stick. Some of the cool things about these LS engines, this is a little bit newer, so this doesn't have a return line on the fuel rails. So you got two fuel rails, you got one inlet, and the fuel pump handles the return. It's got a pressure regulator and everything in it. So, and you get a coil per cylinder. So no distributor. You got a cam sensor, crank sensor, knock sensor, manifold absolute pressure sensor, or MAP. MAP as they call it. And this thingamadoo here is the idle air control / throttle body. We saw that last time. Oh, and the little fuel injectors right there. So I forgot what I was doing. Here I go again. All right. I already made a mess inside here, so let's make another mess. Does is what I'm getting at. It looks janky. Well, if you're just joining us, you should probably just go watch the beginning. Okay, you got the leash?
Got the leash.
Okay. Wow, this is got some heft to it. Here we go.
Right. Okay.
Ready to go down a little bit?
Ready to go down a little bit.
All right. We'll just,
yeah, if we take the fenders off, lift that up, scoot it back.
I think it's just it's the best way to do it. Oh, the torquil bits. Let's shift her forward. know it's in because the back will slide into the groove. I need to go that way. There you go.
There it is. We're going to have to trim up the floor pan.
Show pan.
Right? The new one.
Is that what came in the huge box?
Yeah, I think so.
What you running into there?
Well, things are good. Just want to get that out of the way. You can see this mount right here. This is where it used to kind of sit. So we're not too far up from our mount, but I think we're gonna have to lift it up just a hair because I need to run these two lines. I need to run them straight up because they're just gonna be in the way. Where this is, slid all the way back. We need to go approximately. Puts the back of the motor right here in this little groove. The oil pan should still clear this cross member, and we have plenty of room with this oil pan and everything. I'm very happy with that, so.
Is it running yet?
It's close.
Oh, okay. Is that all you got left?
That's all I got left. It'll run after that, right?
Yeah.
All right, so here's where we're at. So I tried flipping this around.
Yep.
It did scooch me back, but we're still way too far forward. And we're gonna have to cut the mounts. And we're gonna have to re-weld them back further. Okay, start pulling. Hold up. Let me go up just a hair. Hold up. This section right here, let's just cut it out and we can just put a flat piece on the bottom, angle it off. The back of the pan, you can kind of see where it was resting.
Yes.
So it'll be about right here.
Good.
So not a big deal. We're thinking like some headers should fit on there too.
Yeah.
They have some headers that will hug this a little bit closer. That might be better.
Voila.
Yeah. So that's all. That's basically it.
Yeah.
I was about to kick that too. Oh, that's a bolt.
Are they? I thought it was just a little. Oh yeah, it is.
All right.
It's holding it in. Ooh, there's a lot of grease under there.
That's so the bolt comes out easier.
10's too small.
Oh wow.
Dang it.
And
it's an 11.
I bet you it's a 14.
It's even bigger.
I got 12 wrong. Yeah.
This is a 15 on here. I'm surprised it's that big.
Maybe it's a 15.
Definitely not a 22.
No.
It's a 22. I'm just kidding. Yeah, it's 14.
Wow. God.
I mean, how even?
Well, it's just how, like, just for two, they're probably like, we need to throw those on there. We got extra.
I got these left over. Let's throw these in.
You got that. There we go. All right. There we go. I'm glad you noticed that because I was gonna stomp it.
You might actually want to come up with it if you can, because that line's right underneath it.
I mean, yeah.
There you go.
There we go.
Wow.
We don't need a cross member. The brake line's there. We're just gonna try to fit it, and then maybe get some measurements.
And then after that, we can take it for a rip.
Take it for a rip.
Yeah.
Then it'll be done.
Hey.
Hey! Alright, just have some forward pressure on it.
Okay. You're hitting the side of the way. Okay.
Hold on. It's a. We're good. Sounded bad, but it's fine. Okay, that is kind of where I want it. Yeah, this is looking good. So the idea here is we're gonna make a little transmission tunnel, kind of be a bump. It's not gonna be flat. We'll have to get the transfer case on to kind of figure out that angle a little bit more, but As far as the engine goes, a little high on this side because it's not rotating correctly. But yeah, come in here and check this out though. So we're basically a full, here's that where the engine mount used to be, sitting right there. And this is where our new ones are gonna sit, just like right there. So we'll make us our engine mounts and bolt them up right there. And our exhaust all of a sudden fits. I like the way that sits a lot better. We got quite a bit done. Doesn't maybe look like it, but we're kind of to that point where it just takes time to figure some of these things out, you know?
And today we even got to play with fire.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
But we kept it under control, so. Fire. Yeah, we had an actual firefighter. It fights the fire.
Fought it right in the barrel.
Yeah. Next time, we're going to be making some engine mounts and get the engine kind of situated, and then we'll go from there. But yeah, we're just making little one piece at a time.
As Johnny Cash would say.
Yeah, he would say that.
He would say that.
Yeah, like Johnny Cash. Yeah. All right, well, thanks for watching. Catch us next time, and we will see you later.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around it.
What?
I was gonna say, for the video.
Oh.
You should be like, don't we have a knife somewhere? Like, oh yeah, right here.
Okay.
yes.
Do we have a knife somewhere? Like that? Did I do it?
Yeah.
Okay.
But...
oh.
We'll restart it.
Oh.
So we won't use this clip.
Okay. Cut.